Andiyan ang SEC, tapos si Willie Ong, hindi naman Pilipino, Chinese, 45% siya. Si Jack Yang, hindi rin Pilipino, 5% siya. Si Eddie Yang, 5%, 55% sila in violation of the 60-40 ruling of owning the properties. And I think it is incumbent upon the, sa OSG. Attorney, makinig ka naman. Ha? Mag-ano kayo ng adverse claim na dito para mahabol natin tong mga taong ito na binili yung ating mga properties knowingly na hindi naman sila mga Pilipinos. Hindi ba nakikita na ang nangyayari po dito ay nagiging province na tayo ng China? Sa dami ng mga properties na binibili nila, 292 titles dito pa lamang sa Empire 99, 999. O wala pa yung Golden Sun, wala pa yung Pulwin, wala pa yung Yatay Industrial Park, Yatay International, Omni. O ano pa yung hindi naming alam? O ano magiging ano natin dito? Magiging parte na tayo ng China. Alam niyo ba yun? Yun ang repercussion dito and we have to do something about it. And Attorney Suwa, kanina may binanggit ka, so yung Bernice, ang napangasawa, si Dennis Tam. Is that right? Hindi rin natin alam. Hindi nyo napapansin? Ngo, Hong, Si, Yang, An, Ni, Ting, lahat na Chinese na. Invading na to. Invasion na ang pinagagawa natin dito. Attorney.
I think you have to act on it. You recommend to OSG to have an adverse claim dun sa lahat ng property ni Willie Ong.
Your Honor, we will follow up on our request to the OSG on this matter.
When?
When I get back to the office, Your Honor.
Please, yes, ganun sir. Din po kay Eddie Yang. Kasi Eddie Yang was already established that he is a Chinese citizen using Chinese passport. And that passport he's holding, a Filipino passport, he's not using it for the past several years. Eh, BID na mismo ang nagbigay ng record. Now, we are not doing something about it. And this is the interest of this country and the people of this country. Matagal na to, isang taon na to eh. Eh, sumalubong lang tong hearing ni Chairman Barber because of the drugs. And I hope OSG, gawan nyo ng paraan. Di pwede to. Well, in fact, kaya nga, gusto ko sana si Guevara na mismo nandito eh. He was present yesterday doon sa AGK. Tinanong ko rin siya. But now, I think, Chairman, kasi iba yung opinion niya eh. Pinirmahan niya. Eh, ang sinasabi ko, question of presumption of regularity. Okay yun. Pero in this case, may case sa ombudsman. Magkaiba to. Well, in fact, the mayor of Mexico, Pampanga, was already dismissed twice. Eh, wala. Sorry, Chairman, no? Napaka-emotional ko, pero ay, parang walang ginagawa yung mga agencies natin to help us. This is not only an inquiry in aid of legislation. This is also part of our oversight function. How this agency perform their mandate. Kaya, LRA, please.
Yes, Your Honor. We commit to follow up.
When I get dalawa back, po yun. The properties of Willie Long and the properties of Eddie Tiang.
Yes, sir.
And baka yung iba to follow na yun. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, I would like to agree with Congressman Paduano, Chairman at Paduano, kasi established na naman natin eh. Andiyan ang SEC, tapos si Willie Ong, hindi naman Pilipino, Chinese, 45% siya. Si Jack Yang, hindi rin Pilipino, 5% siya. Si Eddie Yang, 5%, 55% sila in violation of the 60-40 ruling of owning the properties. And I think it is incumbent upon the, OSG. Attorney, makinig ka naman. Ha? Mag-ano kayo ng adverse claim na dito? Para mahabol natin tong mga taong ito na binili yung ating mga properties knowingly na hindi naman sila mga Pilipinos. Hindi ba nakikita na ang nangyayari po dito ay nagiging province na tayo ng China? sa dami ng mga properties sa binibili nila. 292 titles dito pa lamang sa Empire 99 999. O wala pa yung Golden Sun, wala pa yung Pullwin, wala pa yung Yatay Industrial Park, Yatay International, Omni. O ano pa yung hindi namin alam? O ano magiging ano natin dito? Magiging parte na tayo ng China. Alam niyo ba yun? Yun ang repercussion dito and we have to do something about it. And Attorney Suwa, kanina may binanggit ka, so yung Bernice, ang napangasawa, si Dennis Tam. Is that right?
Dennis is the sister of Bernice, Your Honor.
Oh, sino yung napangasawa niya na sinasabi mong Pilipina?
The name there is Tan. I do not have the details.
So anong pangalan nung, anong, ang napangasawa ka mo, kaya siya na, na-legitimize as a Filipino because yes. she married a Filipino husband.
Yes, Your Honor.
How sure are we that he is also a Filipino? He's really a Filipino.
I am not in a position.
Ayun. To... same situation kung kay Rudy Ngo. Hindi rin natin alam. Hindi nyo napapansin? Ngo, Hong, Si, Yang, An, Ni, Ting, lahat na Chinese na. Invading na to. Invasion na ang pinagagawa natin dito. Attorney, so we hope that you, together with the Secretary Guevara, you discuss this truthfully, honestly, and with the love of the country. Kasi ibang sitwasyon na itong pinag-uusapan natin dito. Okay?
Yes, Your Honor. I think it is of record that the Solicitor General's office have been consistently acting on the endorsements of the LRA since 1901, Your Honor. So,
As soon as
the LRA endorses attorney,
with your indulgence, consistently.
Don't be a part of those people who are trying to sell our country. We have new Makapilis, and trying to sell the authentic identity of the Filipinos. Yun ang nangyayari sa atin. We are selling the identity of the Filipinos for a cheap price. PSA, you need to reform. Kitang-kita na namin dito sa kongresong ito, sa committee na to, kung sino ang nagbebenta ng prescribed identity of the Filipinos. Kakaunti pa lang itong pinag-uusapan natin. We don't know yet. If we will be able to find out the database of that Ulysses, we will be able to find out ilan ang nagbenta ng identity ng mga Pilipino.
Thank you, Your Honor. OSG, ang sabi lang naman ni Honorable Paduano, kung meron pa tayong pwedeng gawin na paraan na legal, in spite of the fact na merong ruling ang Korte Suprema, ang sinasabi lang naman ng Korte Suprema it solved yung problem of constitutionality, di ba? But are we bereft of any legal actions doon sa mga transactions na hindi tama?
There are remedies, Your Honor.
Yes, yun nga yung tinatanong ni Honorable Paduano kanina. Yes. Kaya tuloy, nasasabi na wala kayong ginagawa Pero, di ba?
Your Honor, I agree with what you're saying. But if you notice, I wanted to be clarified before answering the question. If the question was pertaining to this in particular, and if he's referring to, because he's saying that the Solicitor General already had issued an opinion, and then this is the opinion that he is quoting. But there are remedies, Your Honor, as I mentioned earlier, for example, reversion.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the cancellation of the title issued to a foreign national, Your Honor.
Or us. As the Honorable Fernandez stated, can the state not file an adverse claim? No, yun ang sinabi, narinig mo naman si Honorable Fernandez.
It would be a reversion, Your Honor, is our position. That the property that was the titled property, titled to a foreign national, that should be cancelled and the ownership would revert to the state.
To the state.
Yes.
Okay. I leave it at that. But in so far as the decision of the Supreme Court is concerned, it only ruled on the constitutionality of
constitutional ban, Your Honor, of prohibiting foreign ownership of real property.
Because that was the issue at hand.
Yes.
Yeah.
And in this case, the real property did not go out of the Philippines.
Yeah.
It remained in the ownership of a Filipino citizen.
Yes.
Not go out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair, may I go to Attorney Suwa?
Yes, please. Attorney
Kasi
Suwa.
Ang claim po ninyo, Attorney Suwa, Miss who is that? Vernice Young?
Vernice and Denise Kaya.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, Kaya.
Yeah.
Vernice Kaya.
She acquired her Filipino citizenship 2 years ago.
Thereabouts, Your Honor.
And using or anchoring her basis, the Moya Lim Yao versus Commissioner of Immigration decision of the Supreme Court, right?
That is my understanding, Your Honor.
Yes, which was decided in October 4 of 1971. Right?
Do not have the exact details.
Yeah, I have it here.
Yes, Your Honor.
I have a copy of the decision. Now, according to you claim that Denise Young Bayan?
Sister, yes, Your Honor.
Denise Young?
Yes. Bernice.
Sino yung nag-asawa at ban? Si Vernice?
Bernice.
Si Vernice, okay.
Bernice, Your Honor.
You claim that she acquired Filipino citizenship based on marriage.
Yes, Your Honor, that's my understanding.
That was in 1971, the decision. Was this decision not abrogated by the 1987 Constitution?
I'm not clear.
You're a lawyer.
Yes.
Oh,
that is still
nowhere in the provisions on citizenship of the Constitution. Can you see that an alien who marries a Filipino can become a Filipino citizen?
Yes, I understand. There's no
so
such
how
provision.
How can that be applicable when the Constitution does not say so?
That has been the practice, Your Honor, over the years since my...
Whose practice is that?
That has been practiced with the Bureau of Immigration, Your Honor, for the acquisition of
the Bureau of Immigration then. Bureau of Immigration, yung basis na nag-acquire ng citizenship is a Supreme Court decided in October 4, 1971. But we had a new constitution in 1987. And nowhere in the provisions of citizenship in that constitution, makita natin na pwede yun. Ano po ang masasabi nyo? Sabi ni Attorney Suwa, ginagamit, it has been your practice, according to him.
Mr. Chair, from what I know, although I don't handle this particular type of visa, it's referred to as cancellation of citizenship, cancellation of ACR by marriage. So this is only available to female foreign nationals. Once they marry a Filipino, they can have their ACR cancelled and they can be naturalized as Filipinos. So this action, Your Honor, is approved by the Bureau of Immigration and later affirmed by the Secretary of Justice.
Yeah, but what is your legal basis?
I don't have the exact legal basis, Your Honor, but I undertake to submit it during the next meeting.
Yeah, please submit to us.
Yes, Your Honor.
Binabasa ko yung Article 4 on citizenship. The following are citizens of the Philippines. Those are citizens of the Philippines at the time of the adoption of this constitution. Madam Yang does not fall under this, right, Attorney? Yes. Those whose fathers or mothers are citizens of the Philippines, she does not fall under this also. Tama po? Those born before January 17, 1973 of Filipino mothers, she's not under this also. Kasi both Chinese yung parents niya. Those who are naturalized in accordance with law, that is the question, yung Juan. Yung BI. Di ba? Was she naturalized?
she acquired the Philippine citizenship in accordance with the procedures.
Hindi mo naman sinasagot, attorney, yung tanong ko eh. We know that there's a naturalization process provided for by law. Di po ba?
Yes,
kaya tinatanong ko, did she undergo the naturalization process?
There was no judicial naturalization, Your Honor.
Oh. Yan ang sinabi ko, BI, that is why I want to know whether you have a legal basis of doing this. Kasi kung wala kang legal basis, you are usurping the power to legislate. Tama?
To a certain extent, Your Honor. But as I've said, I'll get back to the committee regarding that. But usually in the certificates, they were quoting the Moya Lim decision, Your Honor.
Yes, but that was in 1971. And we have a new constitution enacted in 1987.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, ano ba? Kaya bugato ka rin yata, di ba?
Yes, sir. Oh. But eventually, Your Honor, all those actions of the Bureau of Immigration are affirmed by the Secretary of Justice. It is not only a unilateral act
by
the Commissioner.
I agree that it is affirmed by the Secretary of Justice. But my question is, what is the basis of the fear exercise of that authority? You must have a legal basis. Otherwise, it's arbitrary and whimsical. Who?
Your Honor, the legal basis would be, as mentioned by Attorney Sua, would be the Moya Lim Doctrine.
Yeah,
but yes, Your
don't
Honor.
Don't you think it has been abrogated by the new constitution when it enumerated those who can become citizens of this country?
No, Your Honor.
What?
No,
it
Your
is
Honor.
Is not abrogated?
No, Your Honor.
No?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, believe din ako sa iyo. You mean to tell me a decision of the Supreme Court contrary to the new constitution, the old Supreme Court decision would still be followed?
Actually, Your Honor, from what I know, it's not contrary to the constitution. But as I've said, Your Honor, I can get back to you
okay.
with the legal basis.
I'll be patient to wait for your legal anchor, attorney.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Acop. Yes,
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Fernandez.
I would like to reiterate my motion a while ago kasi hindi natin nabigyan ng action yung si Hong, the one who bought the property of Eddie Yang, si Ruding Ho be invited in the next hearing. And also, I think the husband of Bernice Kai Yang, which kanina pinag-uusapan po natin to shed light up to all these questions that we are trying to ferret out, yung si Pierre Son Adrian Gotan, ito po yung napangasawa ni Bernice Kai Yang. So may we also invite this person to shed light on his true nationality, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, there's a motion, duly seconded, and hearing no objection, the motion of Congressman Dan Fernandez is approved.
And also, Mr. Chairman, I would like to invite those Chinese nationals who have been caught negotiating with the government agencies on having a Filipino passport, driver's license,
okay.
and using our agencies as a part of their being a Filipino citizen.
Paige, can we ask the Chinese citizens that is in the holding area to be brought here in this committee room? But before that, the chair has an information which I think would need a verification from the. This pertains to some to information relative to the transactions of Empire 999 or a certain Mr. Willie Ong.